As all women that have walked the corridors of this building know, it is not a safe place.
Independent Senator Lidia Thorpe breaking down in tears.
One man followed me and cornered me in a stairwell. No one witnessed what happened in the stairwell, as there are no cameras in stairwells. What I experienced was being followed, aggressively propositioned and inappropriately touched.
Doubling down on bombshell allegations of sexual assault inside the halls of Parliament a day after this.
This person harassed me, sexually assaulted me.
Senator Thorpe.
And the Prime Minister had to remove him from his office.
Senator
and to have him talking about this today is an absolute disgrace.
Thorpe using parliamentary privilege to accuse Liberal Senator David Vann of sexual assault.
I utterly reject that statement, that disgusting statement, outright.
Explosive claims which, hours later, she withdrew to comply with Senate rules.
Yesterday I had to listen to a senator who has made me feel unsafe speak on how important it is to keep women safe in Parliament. This was not an isolated incident. And there are others I could name who have inappropriately touched me.
This afternoon, Vann was sensationally dumped from the Liberal Party room.
Further allegations in relation to Senator Vann have been brought to my attention. At the outset, I want to make very clear that I'm not making any judgment on any individual's guilt or innocence.
The embattled senator, moments later, rising to his feet to refute the allegations.
Senator Thorpe's allegations are concocted from beginning to end. Nothing that she has alleged about me is truthful.
But admitting he did move offices in 2021.
I've acknowledged publicly that I moved offices after an allegation from Senator Thorpe that I made her feel uncomfortable. I agreed to move offices to ensure the avoidance of any misconception.
Vann calling for an investigation into Lidia's claims.
If it were true, she would not be cowering under the umbrella of parliamentary privilege.
I will not pursue legal action against the senator. I will not go to the police, but I will continue to speak out against the abuse and harassment that happens in this building. That is my choice.
Green Senator Larissa Waters joins us now. Senator, you were in the room when Lidia detailed her allegations today. What was your reaction?
Well, it's incredibly distressing, Waleed, when here we are in Parliament House that's meant to be leading the way after having our workplace really brought into disrepute with really strong and incredibly shocking allegations over several years now. And I really thought that we'd started to improve our culture. So it's been a really challenging and distressing week when we've seen allegations of sexual assault, both old and new, being politicised and weaponised for an attempt at political gain. And when we hear the pain and distress expressed by folk making those allegations. So all in all, it's been a really confronting week that I think will have a really poor impact on survivors out there watching their nation's parliament and potentially really being discouraged from speaking out against any harassment or abuse or discrimination that they might be facing in their workplace when they've seen what's happened when you do speak out. It's just horrific.
Lidia has said she won't go to the police. Instead, she's used parliamentary privilege to make these serious allegations. What do you make of that and why won't she go to the police?
Well, I spoke in support of Senator Thorpe in the Senate chamber today and I won't go into any further details in relation to her allegations. But I will say that, unfortunately, women already feel as if the justice system doesn't serve their interests, that they're not believed, they're not supported, and it's very re-traumatising. And I think that's what the Parliament should be focused on, rather than cheap political point scoring like we've seen from some quarters during question time this week. I think we should be focused on strengthening the justice system responses, on cleaning up our own backyard, and on making sure that women feel safe and supported when they come forward with these allegations.
Lidia Thorpe today said that she doesn't feel safe in Parliament House and she's calling for more security guards and cameras to be installed immediately. Is that something you'd like to see?
Well, that's certainly been one suggestion made today. For me, it's a cultural thing and it's a power and privilege thing. And as workplace harassment is in any workplace, when you have people in roles where they feel less privileged and less confident and less able to speak out and perhaps are not familiar with what their rights in the workplace are, as many young people in their first jobs don't know what their rights are, it's a very fraught situation, one that's easy to be manipulated by those with the power. So we need broad-scale cultural change. We need improvements to justice system responses. We need improvements to the culture of Parliament House. We need to show some leadership. People deserve to feel safe and be safe wherever they are, and Parliament needs to do a lot better to set that standard, adhere to it ourselves, and then make sure that we're driving that cultural change for every workplace.
Senator Watera, thanks very much for your time.
Thanks, everyone.
Before we leave that story, we did reach out to Senator David Vann regarding Amanda Stoker's claim. So that's the second allegation. His office has confirmed a statement will be released shortly, but of course we don't have it now. For national 24-hour counselling, helpline and support, you can call 1-800-RESPECT. So that's 1-800-737-732.